the king's favorite. A crowd huddled in boats and scattered in the garden awaited Jesus, and with a parable began. A king had bountiful horses, all of them thoroughbred. But one was special and treated with perks so that he was the prodigy of his kingdom. One day, he rebelled and ran away to another master. The bitter king promised to forgive him. But each day his favorite rebelled more and more. Despite the lashes he took, he didn't want to go back. He would not admit he had done wrong and put all the blame on the king. After several messengers without success, the king sent his sound son. He will speak with an even sweeter love, because of his son is myself, sublimated in love. Friends, know that you are these beloved ones of the King of Heaven. Love us as only a God can love. Come, I am the way, the truth, and the life. When Jesus finished, he took the bag of coins and divided them into 6 parts, one of them much larger. A man all bent over won his share and was healed. To blind men and toward men received money and also healing. Finally, they took Aang mother, whose husband had died at sea. Her struggle was enormous. Alone she had to support and raise her 7 children. Jesus gave her the lion's share. He cherished the children and asked her to be good and instruct them in the law. Sitting right next to him, an old man, realizing that there was nothing left, began to shout indignantly. He said they had come from far away because money was given there. Jesus remained silent, listening to the man's outbursts. Finally, he said, "You should have known by my silence that I recognized you. You are a miser, a thief, and you Libyan prophet. But in respect for your age, I will not take away the purse full of gold that you carry with you." The people wanted to assault the man, but Jesus warned them, "Shut up. If he has lacked honesty, do not lack charity. Each one has his own sin. I needed to shame him, because it is not lawful to steal, even more from poor destitute people." Jesus found himself surrounded by the possessed, the crippled, the blind, all living like animals. He went there. "Come out of them, leave God's creatures," and they were all set free. Jesus was devastated. Friends, I assure you that in Israel are all sins of the world. Demons live here. True possession is that which makes hearts turn against all honesty, all justice, seemed all love, making them a den of violence, wrongs on revenge. Very downcast Jesus could see in them fine-grained spirit of hatred and the unwillingness to change. "Ah, my Father, I have come to this world, but man does not want to be saved.